you cooking up on this one.
Hey, Seismic, boy, you too crazy.
Today, I would just like to apologize for my own absence and for our absence. We've been preparing for season two. We've run out of budget for season one. So what we're gonna have to do now is resort to, we've only got access to what little supplies are left in the stock room, which is basically all the stuff we didn't want to use. 36 volt battery, 1500 watt motor, all of that stuff that kind of is a bit civilian. We're gonna do some normal stuff today. No moon stuff, no space shuttle, no big batteries, no big BMSs, none of that crazy stuff. Just your average, our parts manager, Sean Bay, Sean Express, Shawnee Barber, needs to get to work and back. So something normal. That's today's mission. It's cheap, it's nasty, it's horrible, but we're gonna do it. It's cool, it's Sean Express. We've got to work it up, we've got to build him up. To say we're gonna add more amps to this would be a lie, because there wasn't a single amp in this before, not even a headlight. So yeah, there's not even a single drop of electricity in this at all. It's all manually operated, very old school. We're gonna bring it into the future now. Let's go. First things first is we need to sort out this pedal assist. Sean is a man that enjoys pedal assist. I do not. So what we're gonna have to do is keep Sean Bay, Shawnee Barber, Sean Express happy and add some pedal assist sensors to this. It's not an easy job, because really we even need a special sensor or a special crank. But because we're doing this the cheap and horrible way, we're gonna use a drill, zip ties and some super glue and make it happen. Let's go. For those of you that care, a pedal assist sensor, or PAS system, is a sensor that goes onto these cranks and when pedaled, operates the motor. So as these pedals turn, the motor turns. What we're gonna need to do is take this crank off for starters. We're gonna get some tools. I can't do it with my bare hands, can I? I'm gonna start by getting this thing off. Oh, all the budget for today's video is gone. Season one is completely out of budget, so you're just gonna have to wait for season two, which is coming very soon, where we have fresh budget and fresh allowances. So we'll be able to buy bike stands and cool stuff like that. So that pedal's off. We're gonna get a pedal assist sensor now. Now, if you see this thing here, yeah, this ain't trying to fit on that. We need to get a zoom in on that. We're gonna go to a zoom now. This ain't trying to fit on there. Not even in the slightest. So I'm gonna drill this. That's what we're gonna do. Rough. I don't know if I overdid it there. Go and check. Yeah, man. Sensor. So you may be wondering why I've done the pedal assist sensor first, just because I hate them so much and I thought, let's get that out of the way. Probably one of the more fiddlier bits. I preempted this being no standard crank. So no problems there. Next thing we're gonna do is get this wheel out and replace it for a motor. Let's do that. Right, look at that. We took a quick intermission And as if by magic, look at that. 1500 watts of pure aggression, of pure unbridled power. This will probably take about 45 amps before it smoulders into a pile of dust and magic smoke. But yeah, we're gonna run it nice and sensibly. 36 volt. I think my electric shaver has more volts, but it's all right. 36 volt. Like 5 or 8 amps. No, I'm joking, like 30 amps. Right, so anyway, enough jokes aside, now we're gonna do a very important part some of you DIY guys tend to forget. We're gonna add some tool combs, because these dropouts, to my eyeballs, are looking very skinny. And skinny dropouts will probably get smashed to pieces by this level of power. So what we're gonna do is add some dropouts. I'm gonna find them now. Add some dropouts, add some tool combs. So, I don't think we've done too badly considering this was supposed to be quite janky and quite ghetto, but it actually looks all right. What we've done is we've used 3 zip ties, 1 zip tie to go around the outer perimeter of the bottom bracket and 2 zip ties. Oh, by the way, we took the sensor off the silly ring thing it comes with. And if you're wondering why we've done all this, it's because once again, Sean has got a fancy bottom bracket here that doesn't allow for the ring to sit here with the magnet ring and all the rest of it. Anyway, it's all there, it's all working. Saying Sean Bay, happy with the progress there. Sean Express, your bike is done. We've added a pedal assist sensor, a 1500 watt rear wheel, a KT controller, a very nice streamlined Heilong battery, a nice display up here, some hydraulic brakes. What else? That's it really. Sean is gonna be absolutely buzzing. This is gonna be getting into work and back, flying. As you know. Why don't we test ride Sean's bike? Now I've got a better idea. Why don't we test drive this? Sean's bike is cool, man. It's a cool bike. I'm not digging you, Sean. But unfortunately, the KV car is just cooler and gets more views. So let's do that. So we thought we'd get ahead of the curve and make the floor a little bit wet, so maybe it does less burnout marks on the floor. But it looks like it's actually leaving more marks on the floor. And I haven't got actually any handling at all. So, damn!